Here comes Mr. Nobody walking down the...
Hey, everybody. So today, first off, some sad news. My friend decided he wants to sell some stuff. One of them was the DP-008. So I do not have a DP-008 anymore. It was sold. But that being said, I panic bought his Fender Twin Reverb amp. So now that's mine. Yeah, I bought it. I couldn't let it go. It had to stay here. So it's still here. It's mine now. And I'm buying a power sucker for it because I want to try to get a better tone than what we've been getting because it's just so loud. So that's the news right now. Thank you all for watching the and commenting on the ghost one that I did last week. I will probably do another one closer to Halloween because that just seems like the right time to do it. And yes, I do have more stories. Not in this house, in other houses. My parents' house, for instance. So today, we're going to look at the Model 16. We're going to look at external effects. I still want to do a video comparing the internal effects on the Model 16 to the DP32. DP32 now is sitting over by the drum set there for now. It's covered, just waiting to be used. But I pulled up Mr. Nobody on this thing because I wanted to talk to you about how you can get external effects on this system and how to do it. Now I did notice one glitch. I'm going to tell you about it. The effects port here, if you were to, while it's on, plug it in or pull it out, you literally lock up the system. It is just stops. So you have to turn off, turn it back on. That's something I'm going to let Tascam know. They can probably fix that in a firmware upgrade. But that is, I did that. I'm like, what the heck? Why did it suddenly stop? Because I'm playing with it. I'm trying this. So it didn't work the way I thought it was going to. I'll start with that. So the effects thing, let me bring this up over here. But effects, you have this, the effects insert. Well, it's not an insert, sorry. The effects send. That's all it is. It's a balanced one. So if you want to send it through a balanced line to into something, you can. I was hoping it was an insert, so it would go in and then out. But no. I was quite sad about that because that would be just perfect for this kind of setup. So using it, now once you have it in, you can't use the internal effects. So that's one thing. So the internal effects are now turned off because they can't be used with this. I have my digital delay here plugged into the internal effects. I'm going to show you another way of doing this. This is number one. So it's coming in. It's going around into the going to the digital delay, coming up and going into the red. Now the effects loops, see if we can get this. The effects line is this one right here. And it uses the effects port or the effects system. It's all through the same thing. So now I have it on channel 3, which is the vocals, main vocals. Yes, I know that's weird. That's the way it was with Mr. Nobody. Vocals were on channel 3. So I'll play a bit of it. Start from the beginning.
One, two, three. Here's one, two,
here comes Mr. Nobody
walking down the street. Some speed.
So you can hear it.
Has his eye far, but still he isn't beat. Making music his way, waiting for his chance,
still going. I had it reversed, still going, and it works. So what you have to do is you have to go back into the system on one of the channels, and you would have to record it that way if you want to use it. So that's using just the external effects thing. But because you have so many channels on this thing, outputs, you can do crazy stuff. So you can go, as you can see here, I have my effects. Oh, sorry, let me get closer in here. So in the monitor, I don't want to pull them out because I don't know if they're going to break. Well, in the auxiliary slash monitor outs, put it up there, I have my effects 1 and effects 2, which are going into my rack. And I have set them up on the XLRs here. They're coming back in 7 and 8 on my Snake. And I have them panned out. Because I'm going to show you. Now, this you have to be delicate with. I'm going to be honest with you. So I'm turning off. I'm going to turn off that effect because that was bad. So you need to be delicate with this because it runs hot. So I'm going to put it at about a quarter to start with. So as you can see, so you have to, first things, it's the same with on the DP008 where you have the effects line. You can set it to 127. I always say set it to 127, not on here. You just set it to that much, and then we're going to do it on channel 3 again. So we'll start her over. Start, and I'll bring them
one, up. Two, one, two, three. Here comes Mr. Nobody walking down the street.
As you see, there I have the one up, and it's already like, whoa, that's nice. Yeah. So, like I said, this is, it runs hot, so don't do too much on it. Now, we'll do it again. And this time I'll do it on the other one. This one is more of a slap back and it's a very fast one because I'm using it for a different song. But I will show you.
One, two, one, two, three. Here comes Mr. Nobody walking down the street. Hasn't gotten far, but still he isn't beat.
So there. So yes. So you can use all three of these, let me get my fingers in so you can see them, all of these here to do your effects if you want. It's a nice thing. It takes a little bit of tweaking to get it to work right because it's, like I said, it runs very hot. It's much louder than normal, but it works. And yeah, I would, if you know you got it, use it. That's what it's there for. So talk to you later. Bye.
Here comes Mr. Nobody with guitar in hand, setting up on the corner.